SNES Drunk.
Hi there, and welcome back to SNES Drunk Plays Star Fox. Let's move on to the final planet in the easy setting here. The final goal, Venom. Andross is hiding on Venom. You think? Fox, you must find his core brain? What? And destroy it. Okay. Well, better get going. Yep, that's right. It's another space cockpit level. And, of course, Slippy needs help again. God. How many times is that now? Is that like six times? Can I just kick him off my team? Oh, we got more plasma Cheerios. Oh, and I love these things. This is a fun level because these things come up from the planet surface. And I love trying to get them as close as they can before shooting them. I'm not very good at it sometimes, but I love that. Really adds a level of chaos that I really enjoy. Oh, and we got these little bastard little things that stay invisible and try and shoot lasers at you from like the corners of the screen. I hate that. It's a dick move game. Alright. And these things, you blast them apart and they go into like four different missiles somehow. Not sure how that works. This thing, I think you're supposed to, if you shoot a bomb and blow all those up, I think you get another upgrade, a weapon upgrade, if you haven't had one already. I was talking about that little circle thing back there. Anyway, yeah, this episode's going to be pretty long. Going to go for some length here. I think it's probably going to be about 20 minutes. See, again, I let myself get hit by that thing just because I'm like waiting for it to get like right up next to me before shooting it. But yeah, we're going to finish the game on the easy setting, which is something I have done many a time. I think I've beaten Star Fox more than I've beaten any other game. Are we already at the boss here? No, we're not. We have more of these things and more of that bastard, like, laser. At least he gives up a life ring, but still. Yeah, this level's not the best level. I mean, I do like the thing. Oh, we got another guy in trouble here. Take care of that. It's just basically these things coming at you full throttle, which can be pretty chaotic, especially if you don't have the weapon upgrade. If you're stuck with, like, the single pea shooter, that's a problem. But as it is right now, this is pretty boring, actually. This is the most blah level so far of this campaign, in my opinion. Oh, here we go. Here's an interesting boss. It is the Phantom, Phantasm, I think, or something like that. You have to hit him while he's moving left to right like that with that little trace effect. And once you get him down to a certain point in his life bar, he splits into threes. And two are fake, and one is real. You have to figure out the one that is real, which isn't that hard to do, really. Because once you get the find the one that's real, you just pound the shit out of it with your overpowered weapon. So hey, 5 for 5, no deaths yet. Nobody's gotten hit yet. I've gotten hit plenty of times, but that doesn't seem to matter. You got another hundo? You betcha. And more continues that I won't use. Oh shit, it's on now. I love that music, and I love the angle, the direction here. Oh, and then you see the background. That's so well done. That's one thing this game does very, very well, is build up the drama like that. Here the game decides to like just go ahead and go along with its pop-up issues by just having stuff purposefully pop up and build that you have to dodge. And Slippy's in trouble again. God, I'm getting so sick of that. Does the game purposely make it Slippy? Why isn't it anybody else? I think it was Falco. I was gonna fucking bring him down myself. Anyway, coming up here, yeah, we've got these arrows. Once again, that indicates the direction it is going. Shoot it, and it'll flip, and it'll go in that direction. Pretty simple stuff. That said, this is not a, this is, or I should say, it is and it isn't a fun game to play drunk. because you always, I always, at least for me, manage to screw up and like, oh, the arrow says go that way, you know? And yes, I noticed that Falco was in trouble for once instead of Slippy. Good for him. Way to change it up, game. Really appreciate it. Sorry, I have a bit of a cough. Whoa, that was very close. Coming up here, we've got another interesting little thing where the game throws these pillars at you in your path, but with this powered-up gun, you can pretty much disintegrate them. And it's pretty easy to dodge anyway. It's not that fast. It's a nice idea by the game, but it's limited by the speed of, or the lack of speed, I should say, that presents itself when you're dealing with this much stuff on the screen at once. This is kind of tricky. There's another upgrade if you need one. It's risky to get because then you got shit coming down on top of you, but what's this again? No sweat. I think the boss is after this. And once again, you notice after the last boss fight, I ran away like a coward. Now we've chased him down. And this time, instead of dicking around, he's going to go right into his three forms right away. And I've immediately found his real form there, but if you get him down to just a tiny bit of life, oh shit, it's on now. Yep, full life, and it's time to fuck shit up. He's shooting missiles at you, shooting lasers at you, shooting plasma balls at you. It's got a myriad of attacks that he can do. This is probably the toughest boss up to this point. Or probably, it's definitely the toughest boss up to this point. Because especially because of, oh no, he does this pointless somersault where he tries to land on you and it never works. All you really have to do is hit the brakes there. But he does this move that always catches me off guard. Oh, and I forgot about this. He actually splits into threes in this form too, but it doesn't last very long apparently. I forgot about that. I forgot you could do that. Whoa, dodging this shit. Yeah, it helps to use the L and R buttons to dodge those plasma balls so you can stay on point while you're attacking it. That's another thing, this guy has such a small target area. Oh, here we go. I think this is what it is. Yeah, he didn't do it very well that time, but he will kind of like throw his arm at you, and it extends outward, and it comes out of nowhere so fast that you can't help but get hit. I still took a fair amount of damage there. Anyway, now that that guy's out of the way, there's only one guy left. Let's do a loop-de-loo here, and hopefully the door will open for me. Oh, thank you. That door will open. Oh, thank you. Thank you for letting me right in. And, yep, there's only one person left. Hopefully I won't get fucked. Oh, jeez. This is not good. No. Damn it. The biggest issue... Okay, the biggest... obstacle, I think, with this path, the easy path, is wing damage with stuff like that. Because if you get wing damage, your wing gets like sawed off, and you're left with a pea shooter. Your weapon gets downgraded. Anyway, here we got Andross and the big creepy talking face thing. Oh God! And he tries. I don't think you can actually go in his mouth. So it's kind of pointless to do that. I'm too afraid to try and find out. Anyway, basically have to just stay in one place, go to town on his eyes, split apart the blocks as they come at you, try and dodge what you can. It's a bit too chaotic to see what the hell's going on anyway. He spits out everything at you. Yeah. For some reason, if you just stand in this one spot, at least I don't get hit, ever. So just go to town on his eye. There we go. Now, this will reveal Andross in a cube where you have a limited amount of time to shoot at him, usually about 5 seconds, and that's more than enough time to fuck him up and beat him. So there you go. That can't really be all, can it? And he dies. No, he actually get out just fine. Pretty cool scene there, though. Getting out of the underground base, exploding base. Great looking backgrounds there. Very cool pixel art. And everybody's at full health, except for me. At least I think everybody's at full health. The only drama left here is if I got that last 100%. I think I was perfect up to this point. Anyway, nice demonstration of the Super Effects chip here. Great little design. You know, obviously to some people this is gonna, these ships and these graphics are gonna look super dated and clunky and very Atari-ish because there's no textures, it's just all polygons. But I like what they did with the art style. I like how they designed. They obviously put a lot of thought in the design of the ships themselves. They look really nice to this day, in my opinion. All right. Hundo. Here we go with the Hundo of Stage 5. What? 83? What a freaking... Boy, that just knocked my dick in the dirt. What a bunch of crap. 83. After 100%? Come the fuck on. Well, 97 average is still okay. Ugh, what a bummer. Oh, man.
Come in, Cornelia.
This is a big moment here.
This is Cornelia, Pepper speaking. Congratulations on a job well done.
Roger, I'm heading back to Cornelia.
Very cool at the time. It really felt like a reward for finishing the game to be able to hear that. Anyway, here's another thing I really like is when they detail all the bosses that you just beat. Let's take a look. Attack carrier, missile blaster. Excuse me. And they show his size. I don't know if those are meters. If I had to guess, I'd say those are meters. Or maybe it's some kind of space measurement or something. I don't know. Level 1. Asteroid. Rock crusher. Weapon. Laser. Yeah, that guy was not a threat whatsoever. Oh well. Here we got the energy core. And again, his weapon, I think, is going to be listed as laser. Hey, Andross, if you want a more effective defense army, you might want to come up with a weapon better than laser for all your bosses here. Now, if I remember correctly, this guy's called like a mosquito boss or something. Oh, Dancing Insector. Yeah, I love that. See, the Fire Blaster. That's a cool weapon. That's one of my favorite bosses in the game. Here we have the Phantasm. Phantom? Something? Fantron. Sorry. Close enough. Again, with the deadly laser. So effective. And here we've got the Mutant Fantron. Doing somersaults and stuff. Not very big compared to these other weapons. And of course the creepy Andross face. It was creepy then and it's even creepier now. Why the ellipses? Andross, there might be more to that. I can't remember. Telekinesis is his weapon. That's interesting. All right, anyway, I will fast forward through these credits just so they're on there, you know, to give proper credit to the people that made this game. Maybe I should just talk over the credits, too. Whatever. So how was your day? How's everybody else's day so far? I've just been playing, you know, Star Fox and stuff. This is the inherent problem with Let's Plays, especially when you get to the ending and you've got these... You got stuff you gotta talk over. I ain't got shit to say. You know, it makes me think of Mystery Science Theater episodes when they had movies that they had to... talk over the credits, and they, behind the scenes, they said they had a lot of trouble coming up with stuff to do, for credits, stuff like, you know, like, what do you talk about, what do you say, you gotta come up with jokes and stuff like that. Sometimes they do, like, skits and stuff like that. Like, I remember at the end of, Rousedower, what's the Rousedower movie, Final Sacrifice, they do, like, a quick skit about, like, spinning off Final Sacrifice into a TV show where they change the settings to like Alabama or something like that. And of course, my favorite is at the end of Escape 2000, where they sing along to the credits song. Crow plays guitar and Mike is annoyed. So I'm playing this on the Retron 5, which was sold to me by a fellow Reddit mod at the Super Nintendo subreddit. Thanks, dude. Appreciate it. Shout out to that guy. Shout out to WW Coop. Hey, look, it's Ben Cheese. One weird thing about this, though, is when I was doing a test run of this, for some reason, on the Retron 5, I'm recording this on the Retron 5, the credits here get slowed way down and the music gets out of sync. So what's going to happen here is, I think, is the music's going to finish. Yeah. See, the music's done. The credits are still going. They're supposed to match up, obviously. There's still about a minute to go here. And that's because I think this effect here, for whatever reason, or we're going to get blasted by an H here, slows down and gets stuff out of sync, which is kind of weird. I've never seen that before. But, yeah. Got some more time to kill. I wonder if we'll get hit by a letter here. I think we'll just barely miss. If you're still watching at this point, God bless you. You're fantastic, because I've run out of stuff to say for a while. I do plan, like I said at the beginning, I do plan on doing the medium and the hard levels as well, paths rather. So thanks, as always, thank you so much for watching, and have a great rest of your day.